Hey, what's going on, little dragons? How are you feeling today? If you're feeling good, please do let me know down in the comments below. Drop a like on this video, share this video with your friends and family, and don't forget to punch that subscribe button, my little dragons, as it will help your little dragon out. So very much. Today, I wasn't actually planning on making a video today. I have to go somewhere, you know. Look at the time. Boom, boom, boom. So, yep, I have to go somewhere in a bit. In a couple of hours, but you know, I just figured, because this crossed my eyes, literally I just saw this when I was just surfing through YouTube. I literally came across this video. I was like, you know, I need to make time. If I don't have time, I need to make time, you know. So that's why I reacted to it now. By the time you're seeing it, probably a couple of days have passed, but all the same, you know, reacting to a good video like this, or the way it looks, I don't know if it's a good video or not, but it just looks like a very interesting video. So probably, you know, I can go through anything, I can go through any pain right whatsoever to go through this video. So right now I'm ready, and I know this video is going to be long already, but I'm not going to be pausing it as much as I do as my other videos, because I keep pausing it, right? I keep pausing it to give you my, you know, what I think, what I feel, my opinions on what's going on. But this one already, since it's going to be really long, it's already about 19-20 minutes long video, I'm not going to, you know, pause and waste time that way. So yes, today we're going to be reacting to History of the Entire World, I guess. It says I guess. So I think, I have a feeling that this is going to be like a, you know, like a quick, considering the views, very, very nice, very good. It has to be, that's why so many people like it, but considering my initial, you know, impression of it is like, it's going to be so super quick, you know, the video is going to be very, very vague. They're not going to go too deep into it, but they're just going to like, you know, this war happens, or this is the reason, that is the reason that happened, or I think it starts from evolution, that's just what I'm guessing, maybe from dinosaurs, or does it start from humanity? Who knows, man? Well, we're gonna find out. So without further ado, let's hop right into this, my little dragons. Let's go.
That's really
interesting.
Ah, you're on a rock, floating in space. Pretty cool, huh? Some of it's water. Okay, actually most of it's water.
I can't All right, get it swearing.
There without buying a boat. It's sad. I'm sad. I miss you.
How did this happen?
A long time ago, actually never, and also now, nothing is nowhere. When? Never. Makes sense, right? Like I said, it didn't happen. Nothing was never anywhere. That's why it's been everywhere. It's been so everywhere, you don't need a where. You don't even need a when. That's how every it gets.
Okay. Is this the Big Bang Theory? From the whole universe? Because everything came from nothing, that's like the theory of the Big Bang, isn't it?
Get this. I want to be something. Go somewhere. Do something. I want things to change. I want to invent time and space. And I know it's possible because everything is here, and it probably already happened. I just don't know when to start. And that's exactly where it started. Oh, I paused it. I think there's a universe now. What's it made of?
Quarks and stuff.
Ah, that's a thing. In a place. Don't like it? Try a new place. At a different time. Try to stick together, because the world is going to get bigger and emptier. But it's not empty yet. It's still very full, at about a jillion degrees. Great news, the quarks are now primary in groups of three, called a proton or a neutron. And there's something else flying around too that wants to join in, but can't because it's still too hot.
Too hot.
Great news, the protons and neutrons are now happily married to each other.
Damn it. I have to pause it right now because there's going to be an ad. But, well, so, okay, not the whole world. They're gone from the whole universe. They're gone from all the dark matter. You know, everything, nothing, everything comes from nothing, that thing. So, yeah. Interesting. Hold up. Okay, let's go.
Great news, the protons and neutrons are now happily married to each other. Some of them even doubled up.
Hydrogen.
Great news, the electrons have now joined in. Congratulations, the world is now a bunch of gas in space. But it's getting closer together. And it's getting closer together.
Where's gravity come from?
And it's getting closer together.
Good question.
Shit just got made. Some stars burn out and die. Bigger stars burn out and die with passion that makes some brand new, way crazier shit. Which allows newer, more interesting stars to be made and then die and explode into the
Lord.
So now stars have cool stuff around them.
Sometimes
they have ice and funny clouds, which can make some very interesting things. Like this ball of flaming rocks, for example. Holy shit, we just got hit with another ball of flaming rocks. And it kind of made a mess, which is...
Really?
Raining rocks from outer space. Weather update, those rocks might have had water inside them, and now there's hot steam in the sky. Weather update, cooler temperatures today, and the core is no longer lava. Weather update, it's raining. Severe flooding alert, the entire world is now an ocean.
Yeah, the depressions inside the earth, the crusts, that's what causes water. Like seas and rivers and stuff.
Oh cool, like a plant or an animal? No, a microscopic speck. It lives at the bottom of the ocean and eats chemicals.
That's
soup,
us.
Which is being served hot and fresh, made right. From gnarly space ingredients left over from when it was raining rocks or whatever. Oh yeah, and it can do that. It has secret instructions written inside itself telling it how to build another one of itself. So that's pretty nifty, I would say. Tired of living at the bottom of the ocean?
Now you can eat some light.
Using a revolutionary technique, you can convert sunlight into food.
Nature's genius, man. Seriously, nature is a genius.
A snowball for a while, maybe even a couple of times. It's a sponge, it's a plant, it's a worm, and some other types of weird, strange water bugs and strange fish.
It's the Calgary explosion.
Oh, really?
Wow, that's animals and stuff. But we're still in the ocean. Hey, can we go on land?
No.
Why? The sun is a deadly laser. Oh, okay. Now the animals can go on land. Come on, animals, let's go on land. Nope, can't walk yet. And there's no food yet, so I don't care.
100 million years later, you
maybe
are
set some bugs and fish.
What? Amphibians.
Okay, so I can go on land, but I have to go back in the water to hit. Learn to use an egg.
I was already doing that.
Use a stronger egg. Put water in it. Have a baby on land in an egg. Water is in the egg. Baby in the egg, in the water.
Wow, it's mind-blowing because this is over the course of billions of years.
And now everything's huge, including bugs. Want to see a map of the land? Sure. Oh, fuck, now everything's dead. Just kidding, you're the survivors. Keep your eye on this one because it's about to become the dinosaurs. Here's another map of the land. That broke apart, don't worry about it. It does that all the time. Here comes a meteor.
And the dinosaurs are gone.
It's mammal time. Here come the mammals. Look at those breasts. Now they're going to dominate the world. One of them is
going to
grab stuff. Walk, no, like walk like that, and grab stuff at the same time, and bang rocks together to make
evolution
rocks. Ouch, and set things on fire. Youch, and make crazy sounds with their voice, which can mean different things.
That's a human person.
And now they're everywhere.
Almost. Wow.
What? You can walk over here? Cool.
Well, mind blowing.
Let's review. There's people on the planet, and they're chasing the food. Okay, time to plant some grass. Look at this. I control the food now. Now they're going to want to be my friend and live near me. Let's all build houses, except mine is bigger because I own the food. This is great. I wonder if anyone else is doing this. Tired of using rocks for everything? Use metal. It's underground. Better farming was just invented in a sweet dank valley right in between these two rivers. And the animals are helping.
Guess what happens next?
More food. And more people who came to buy the food. Now you need people to help make the food and keep track of the sales. And now you need houses for people to live in.
Yeah.
And now there's more people and they invent things, which makes things better. And more people come and there's more farming.
The funny thing is we can control energy also.
Business, money, like the writing, laws,
it's crazy. The light and, you know, the light that you're looking at me at right now through this camera.
Meanwhile, out of the middle of nowhere,
it's crazy, like, us humans were able to control all these things.
Tired of using lame, sad metal? Introducing made with special ingredient tin from the far lands of Tinland. I don't know, my dealer won't tell me where he gets it. Also, guess what?
Lucky, we should be blessed to be humans.
Meanwhile, out of the middle of nowhere, they figured out how to put wheels on a horse. Now we're getting somewhere. Also,
China.
Did I mention
civilization?
Middle East is getting more complicated. Maybe because it's in the middle of the East. Knock, knock, or clop, clop. It's the people with the horses. And they made an empire. And then everyone else copied their horses.
Greeks!
Ah, look, it must be the Greeks, or a beta version of the Greeks. Let's check in with the Indus River Valley civilization. They're gone. Guess who's not gone?
China. New arrivals in India.
Maybe it's those horse people I'm talking about. Cousins or something.
You're taking over the country, yeah?
And they wrote some hymns and mantras and stuff. We could make a religion out of this.
Hinduism,
the Bronze Age collapsed.
Now the Phoenicians can get down to business.
Also, can we switch to a metal that's a little easier to find? Thanks. Look who came back to Israel. It's the 12 tribes of Israel.
And they believe in God.
Just one, though. He's got like a 10-step program. There's some huge heads. Must be the only
Judaism.
The Phoenicians make some colonies.
Is it?
Greeks copy their idea and make some colonies. The Phoenicians make colonies so big, makes colonies. Here comes the Assyrian Empire. Then along, it's the Babylonic Media.
It's the Persian Empire.
Wow, that's big.
Wow.
The Buddha was just enlightened. Who's the Buddha? This guy, who sat under a tree for so long that he figured out how to ignore the fact that we're all dying. You can make a religion out of this. Oops, China just broke, but while it was breaking, Confucius was figuring out how to have good morals. Ah, the Greeks just had the idea of thinking about stuff. And right over here, Alexander just had the idea of conquering the entire Persian Empire. It's a great idea.
This is all before Christ, is all over.
Hopefully the rest of the gang will be able to share the empire evenly between them. I'll get Chandragupta. He says, get the hell out of here. Will you get the hell out of here if I give you 500 elephants? Okay, thanks, bye.
Time to conquer all of India.
That's the Tamil kings. No one conquers the Tamil kings.
Tamil. I'm Tamil. Tamil kings. I'm Tamil.
And they've got spices. I'd like to buy the spices. Me, said the Arabians, with the value and selling to the rest of the world. Hey, China put itself back together again. Good morals is their main philosophy. Actually, they have three main philosophies. Out here, the horse nomads run wild and free, and they would like to ransack your city. Let's check the Greekification levels of the Greekified kingdoms. Greekification overload. Bye, said the Parthians. Bye, said the Jews. I, said the Parthians, taking over the entire place. Hey, said the Romans, eating the entire Mediterranean.
Wow. Breakfast.
Thanks for invading our homeland, said the Jews, who were starting to get tired of people invading their homeland. Hi, everything's great, said some guy who seems to be getting very popular. Is there a message to kill for being too popular, which only makes him more popular? You can make a religion out of this. Well, still, yeah. Now you can buy from China. They just made a...
Wow.
Sick, new trade routes, said India, accidentally spreading the religion to the entire Southeast.
It's Buddhism.
An epic trading kingdom. There goes Buddhism traveling up the Silk Road. I wonder if it'll reach China before it collapses again. Remember the Persian Empire? Yep, so the Persians making a new one. Axum is getting so powerful that we'd like to build a long...
I thought Buddhism went to China before, okay. Let's do it. I've always thought that Buddhism went to China before, before Christ.
Still can't cross the Sahara Desert? Try camels.
Hell yeah.
It's the water.
Empire selling lots of gold. That's like, hi, I live in the Roman Empire, and I was wondering, is loving Jesus needed? No. Actually, okay, sure, said Constantine, moving capital way over here to be closer to his main rival. Don't worry about Rome, it won't fall.
It's the golden age.
See, Indios are very crazy.
The first.
Amazing country.
It's a barbarian. Non-Romans, said the Romans, being invaded by non-Romans. R.I.P. Roman Empire. Actually, just half of it. The other half is just fine. But it's not in Rome anymore, so let's give it a new name.
The Mayans have figured out the stars.
Oh, wow.
There's a huge city, population, everyone. The Goat Turks.
The Mayan clan.
The entire Eurasian steppe. Great job, Goat Turks. How's India? Broken. How's China?
Back together.
How's those trading kingdoms?
Bigger and there's more of them.
Korea has three kingdoms. Japan has a kingdom. It's the Sunrise Kingdom. Deep in the Arabian Desert, on top of the mountain, the real God whispers in Muhammad's ear. So
he visits the Q-Arbor
gods and he tells them their gods are all fake. And everyone got so mad at him that he had to leave town and go to a different town. You can make a religion out of this and maybe conquer the world as well. The Roman Empire is long gone, but somehow the Pope is still the Pope. Plus there's... I wonder if there's room for more. Here's all the wisdom. In a house. It's the Baghdad House of Wisdom, just in time for the
Islamic Golden Age.
Let's bring stuff to the coast and sell it and become the Swahili on the Swahili coast, said the Swahili on the Swahili coast. Remember this tidy space you have to go through to get from here to there? Someone owns that now. Why didn't blame them in the door? The Franks have the biggest kingdom in Europe, and the Pope is so proud that he invites the king over for Christmas. Whoa. Surprise, you're the new Roman Emperor, said the Pope, pretending to still be part of the Roman Empire. Then the Franks broke their kingdom into what will later be called France and not France. The Northerners, are just
France and not France,
time, are exploring. They go north, from the north to the northern north, and they find some land, two types of land, and they name them accordingly. They also invade some other places and get called many names, such as Vikings.
Vikings?
The Rus, the Kievan Rus. Are they Vikings? I don't think so, said the Kievan Rus.
Sweden.
Okay, fair enough. The Pope is ready to make some more emperors of the Roman Empire, the Holy Roman Empire. It's actually Germany, don't worry about it. New kingdoms. Which brand would you like? Mine's better. Time to conquer England, said William. It's a bird, it's a plane.
It's the Seljuk Turks,
said the Byzantine Empire, who's getting so small and almost doesn't exist anymore. They need help, so they call the Pope. Hey Pope, can you help us get rid of the Seljuks? Can you take back the Holy Land on the way? Come on, I know you want to take back the Holy Land. Yes, I do actually want to do that. Let's do a crusade. They did many crusades, some of which almost didn't fail, but at least the Italians got some sweet trade deals. Goodbye, Mayans. Goodbye, Toltecs.
Come on.
Look at those mounds. There's the Pueblo. I always wondered how to build a town in a cliff. Guess who's here? Come here. Where? Here. And Pagan is there. Vietnam unconquered itself. Korea just became itself. And Japan is so addicted to art that the military might have to take over the government. China just invented...
Oh, no. Did they?
The Mongols just invaded most of the universe. Nice going, Genghis.
Okay.
I bet that
would
last a long time.
So yeah, he killed them.
Were unaffected by the Mongol invasions because they were busy invading India. Is it Tonga time? I think it's Tonga time. I just found out where the Swahili gets all the gold. Look at this Chad. It means lake. There's an empire there, right in the middle of it. The king of Mali is so rich he's going on tour to let everyone know. Wow, that guy's rich, everyone said. The Christians are doing a great job reconquering Iberia, which will soon be called Spain and not Spain. Please remain Christian. We will check in later to see if you're still Christian when you least expect. Whoops, half of Europe just died. China's back, yay! Hey, come here, time to share. New kingdoms here and there. Oh, look who controls all the islands. It's the Mahajapit, Majahapit, Mahapajahit, Mahapajit, Mahapajahit, Mahapajahit. Oh, Japan's really rich. Time for them to care a lot about art and the ancient classics. It's kind of like a rebirth. Here's a printer. Let's make books. So you think you can conquer the Byzantine Empire? Yep, said the Ottoman Turks. Nice job, Ottoman Turks. Oops, you missed the spot. Don't forget to ban Europe from the Indian spice trade. What? That's bullshit, said Portugal. Spiceless. Well, I guess we'll have to
find another way to India. Some reason.
Wait, said Christopher Columbus, probably smoking crack. If the world is round, let's go this way to India. No, don't worry, we already got this, said Portugal. So Chris goes to Spain. Hey, Spain, want to hire me to
find America, yeah.
Back in the world? No, please, no, please, no, please. Okay. So he sails into the ocean and discovers more ocean, and then discovers the Indies and Japan. Let's draw a line to decide who gets which half of the world. The Aztec and Inca empires are off to a great start. I wonder if they know that Europe just discovered their homeland. The Habsburgs are marrying into so many royal families they might have to start marrying each other. Move over, Lithuania. Here comes Moscow. Ivan wants to make Russia great again. Move over, Tiberias. Maybe go into India or something. Persia just made Persia Persian again. Let's make it the other kind of Islam. The one where we thought the first guy should have been the other guy. Hey Christians, do you sin? Now you can buy your way out of hell. That's bullshit. This whole thing is bullshit. That's a scam. Fuck the church. Here's 95 Reasons Why, said Martin Luther in his new book, which might have accidentally started the Protestant Reformation. You know what would be magnificent, said Suleiman, wearing an onion hat? What if the Ottoman Empire was really big, which it is now? What if Russia was big, said Ivan, trying not to be terrible? Portugal had a dream that they controlled the entire Indian Ocean, including the spice trade. And then that dream was real. And Spain realized that this is not India, but they pillaged it anyway. Damn, said England and France. We gotta start pillaging some stuff. Then the Dutch revolt and all the hipsters moved to Amsterdam. Damn, said Amsterdam. We gotta start pillaging some stuff. Question one, can you get to India through North America? No, but at least there's beaver. Question two, steal the spice trade. That's not a question, but the Dutch did it anyway. Guess where all the sugar's made? In Brazil, stolen, in the Caribbean. It's so goddamn profitable, you might forget to not do slavery. The next thing on Russia's to-do list is to get bigger. Britain and France are having a friendly discussion about who should control the entire world, specifically Ohio. Then it escalates into a 7-year discussion, giving Prussia a chance to show Austria who's boss. But what about Britain and France? Did they figure out who's boss? Yes, they did. It's Britain. Guess who's broke? Also Britain. So they start taxing the hell out of America. Fuck you, says America, declaring their independence and fighting for it. And France helps them win. Now France is broke. Britain will have to send their prisoners to a different colony.
Yeah, sure.
This is broke. Why do the king and queen still wear such fancy dresses? Let's overthrow the palace and cut all their heads off, said Robespierre, cutting everybody's head off until someone eventually got mad and cut his head off. You can make a little bit about doing. Lady is starting to like the idea of a revolution, especially the slaves who free themselves by killing their masters. Why didn't you think of this before? Wait, who's in charge of France now? Said Napoleon, trying to take over Europe. Luckily, they banished him to an island.
He came
to Latin America, becoming independent in the Latin American Wars of Independence. Britain just figured out how to.
Isn't Napoleon one of the bravest guys in history?
Invent some trains and conquer India and maybe put some trains there. Hey, China, said Britain. Buy stuff from us. Nah, dude, we already got everything, says China. So Britain tried to get them addicted to opium, which worked, actually. But then China made it illegal and dumped it all into the sea. So Britain threw a hissy fit and made them open up 5 cities and give them an island. Britain and Russia are playing a game where they try to stop each other from conquering Afghanistan. Also, the Sultan of Oman lives in Zanzibar now.
What?
It's just where he lives. India just had a revolution and they would like to govern themselves now. I hope, said Britain, governing them even harder than before.
Technology is about to go crazy.
Yeah.
The United States finally figured out
how big the world is. It comes down to something small because of technology.
Manifesting their destiny, which is to kill the rest of the natives and take their land and maybe kick out the Mexicans too. I know, let's rape Africa, said Europe, scrambling to see who could rape it the fastest. Britain and France are still hungry. The United States ran out of destiny to manifest, so they're looking for more. Wait, Spain controls Cuba. Oh, blame something on them and go to war. What should we blame on Spain? Let's blame the main on Spain. So they blame the main on Spain. Now we're in business. To celebrate, they kick Panama out of Panama and make a canal, connecting the two oceans. Britain just found oil in the Middle East. China is so tired of being bossed around that they delete their old government and make a new, stronger government, which is accidentally weaker and controlled by a guy from the previous government. Europe hasn't had a war since the last war, so to start World War I, look at those guns. It's going to be a great war, so great we won't need a second one. After it's over, they blame Germany. Russia went on strike, and the workers overthrew the government. Now everyone's paycheck is the same. In the Soviet Union, the Arabs rebelled and Britain helps. Now the Ottoman Empire's gone, so we can give the Jewish people a place to live. Hopefully the Arabs won't mind. Let's cut the cake, said Sykes and Picot, carving up the remains of the not-so-Ottoman-anymore empire. Except Turkey, Turkey makes a brand new turkey. And then the Saudis conquer Arabia. It just seemed like the right thing to do. Hello? Yes, it's the 1920s caller. Let's get in the car and drive to a party and listen to jazz on the radio and go to the movies. The economy's great and it'll probably be great forever. Just kidding. Germany back, featuring Hitler, the angry mustache model. And he's mad at the Jews for existing. Japan is finally conquering the East, and they're so excited they raped men came way too hard. They should probably just deny it. Hitler's out of control, so the international community tackles him and tries to explain why killing all the Jews is a bad idea. But he kills himself before they can explain it to him.
Yeah. That's World War
II. Bonus round, Pacific Showdown. United States versus Japan. Fight. Finish it. Let's unite all the nations and have some
world peace.
Hi, I'm Gandhi, and if Britain doesn't get the hell out of India, I'm going to starve myself in public. Wow, that worked. Bonus, now there's Pakistan. Actually, two Pakistans. One of them could be Bangladesh later. The Jews and the Arabs finally figured out which one of them should live in the Holy Land.
Each and every one of these things, like, itself, it's like, it's crazy how much... You can make a this long video, twice as long as this, just explaining each and every one individually. That's how crazy it is.
I wonder which one is the real China. There's the Korean War.
Wow, this guy's small. Very small.
Let's meet the sponsors. Oh, it's the two global superpowers. They're having a friendly debate over which economic system is good and which one is an evil virus of Satan. And they both have atom bombs. Fight! Wait, no, that will be the end of the world. Let's just keep it cool and spy on each other instead. And make sure we haven't have atom bombs. I'll race you to space. Now let's make some more countries fight themselves. Europe is tired of pillaging other continents, and the continents they were pillaging were tired of being pillaged. So here's a new map with new countries. Now you can't tell who they're being pillaged by. The United States finally decided whether racism is good or bad. They decided it's bad, and the world agrees. South Africa might need another minute to think about it. Let's check the world population. Whoa. Okay. Technology's better too, that might keep happening. The Soviet Union decides to relax a little and accidentally falls apart. Europe makes a union, so now they can all use the same money, except Britain, because they don't feel like it. Let's check the mail. Surprise, it's on the computer. Whoops, someone just attacked America. I bet they'll remember that. Phone call. Surprise, it's in your pocket. Wanna learn everything? Surprise, it's on the computer. Now your phone's a computer, which is in your pocket. Whoops, the economy just crashed. Don't worry, the big banks won't fail, because they're not supposed to. Surprise, flying robots. The bombs. Want a printed brain? Some people have no friends. Some people have no food. The globe is warming. Let's save the planet, said everybody, not knowing how. Let's invent a thing inventor, said the thing inventor inventor after being invented by a thing inventor. That's pretty cool. By the way, where the hell are we?
Okay. So that's the theory of evolution. So in the end, they started off with the technology, yes, like right now, who knows where this technology is going to go. I mean, right now, look, think about it. You have a phone for everything, like you can't, it's like part of your body now. Most people, you always have it around your hip. You can't, loads of people can't even go a couple of minutes, you know, without looking at their phone. In the future, they're probably going to bring something even more that's even more convenient. You know, I've seen somewhere that they're going to bring like more like 3D, so you can watch a video like virtual reality, but you can go around and watch it. So if you were watching me in my house or something, you can actually go 3D and watch everything. You know, every part of the room is crazy. But that's mad. So the more technology grows, there's probably going to be more problems. I don't know. You know, there might be, there might not be, but. Wow. One of the things that he says is, you know, the evolution, theory of evolution, and then he says Hinduism after that. In Hinduism, my family's a Hindu, but I'm an atheist, but still. In Hinduism, there's a thing called the avatar, Das Avatar, as in the 10 forms of Vishnu, right? If you take away the religious side of it and you just look at it for what it is, that is also the theory of evolution. So it's crazy because they were able to find this out back then, even like before all of this. And then, you know, ideas and knowledge all started to grow. I'm not saying that that's where knowledge and science came from, but it's crazy. Like, that's the theory because it starts off, you know, in the water. If you go and see it, you know what I mean, starts up in the water, and then water and land, and then on land you're like an animal, you eat everything, and then from that to human to smarter human, and then eventually grows in mechanical man kind of thing. And in the future, I reckon we're going to be cyborgs in the future. So there's so much to, I don't know, to look forward to, but there's so much that we've grown so far this many years. Now think about how long this earth is going to be. So how far we're going to go in the future, which is, it's, I don't know what to think about that, man. Imagine that, being half human, half robot, or being immortal, you know. One of the superpowers, you know, if you ask me what superpower do I want, probably immortality. Because that's what, that'll be cool, you know. You get to see like how everything, you know, changes, how technology changes, how everything changes. I wonder what this video is going to be like. So in a few like 100 years or something, if they come back to this video, hopefully they, the next generations were able to add on to this video and be like, this, all of this happened. So it's bright, amazing. There's a big future ahead of us, man. Hopefully with all those wars and all those killings and stuff that happened that you mentioned about Genghis Khan and all of, you know, the World War I, World War II crusades. Hopefully these sort of things do not happen. Hopefully we share love and spread love. Like how, you know, with racism, you said that America debated, should we keep racism, should we leave it? No, let's you know, leave racism, throw it away, and everyone be together. Hopefully that love, you know, carries on throughout the whole world, racism or whatever kind of thing, or the divisions, everyone's religion or race or whatever they believe in or whatever their orientation is, regardless of all of that, we can all be one big family. This earth is just one big family, and be happy, you know. I don't know, I'm just a kid, what am I saying? That's just what I feel. But it's in their hands. It's in the world's hands. It's in your hands. You are the future. The craziest one, a couple of things, like, you know, Buddhism's growth in China and all of that, they say. I've always thought that was before Christ, but they're obviously telling me after Christ that went to China, which was crazy. And Sikhism, they didn't mention much about Sikhism. That also exists in India. Wow, that's mad. There's another thing that you noticed here, that's that one country is not just better than another country. Every country has its own thing. Some countries it has oil, some countries it has gold, you know, everything is good in its own way. That's something I noticed, and that's something I preach as well. That's one thing I say about you. Be good in your own way. Don't try to be like something else. You have something about you that's unique to you, that makes you special, that makes you amazing. So, you know, stick to that and be one. Hopefully you like this video, man. I know I enjoyed this video. Yeah, I was supposed to react to some World War One. I already did a reaction to World War One. I still have to react to that. That's what I'm learning, all these things, like, in more in depth. If there's anything like history and stuff, you let me know. I'm still watching and learning more about these things, so I'm very enthusiastic as well. But yeah, this one, I can see why people like it so much, because it basically covers everything. So yeah, that's it. That's all I have to say. This video is going down on one of my favorites. I'll probably check this out again, you know, by myself again. Give it some time, we'll learn about what we're doing. I'm still doing my reactions to some history videos, so when I do those, I'll visit this one more time. Not here on this channel, obviously, because I think this one is enough, but again, I'll revisit and see, like, I could be more like, okay, this is that, because there is obviously some things that we didn't understand, like some of the wars and, you know, some of the deep depths, because they skim through it, but when you understand it, you're like, okay, that's what it is. So be sure to stay tuned for that, man. Thank you so much for watching, my little dragons. If you enjoyed this video, drop a like, share this with your friends and family, and punch that subscribe button, as it'll help your little dragon out so very much, man. I love you all. You're all amazing. You're all awesome, man. Stay home, stay safe, stay blessed. Stay awesome, my little dragons, and I will definitely see you all in the next video.